Hey YouTube, this is Lucy from keepbeautyharbor.com. Today I want to talk to you about some of my recent empties. I have quite a few here, so each one will be a brief review. But if you have any questions, leave me a comment and I will put links to everything in the description box. And if I have full reviews for them on my blog, I'll put a link about that as well. Let's get into it. First one is the Neogen Real Fresh Foam Cranberry. Not going to lie, I bought this for the packaging. I mean, look how cool this is. They're actual real cranberries on the bottom. This line also has a blueberry cleanser, an oat cleanser, and there's something else. Green tea. And all of them have stuff on the bottom, which is kind of cool until you get to actually the bottom of the product. And you can't quite get all of that foaming wash out. I tipped the bottle this and that way and used up what I could, but it was a little bit annoying because this thing was full all the way with that liquid cleanser, but the little straw there only goes to here. So, but fine. Sounds like my son has something to contribute to this video. So this was really underwhelming, actually. I expected more because I like Neogen quite a bit, but I don't have any strong feelings about this as far as it being fantastic or anything. It smelled strangely familiar, but not in a good way. It smelled like kind of a cheap hand soap. I really did not like the smell, but also it has this horrendously long ingredients list. This entire thing right here is its ingredients list. And I mean, was that really necessary? It was positioned as something that would be okay for sensitive skin. It says 100% naturally brewed, but all of that, this right here screams to me that it could have potential for irritating the skin. I didn't have any bad reactions. It was fine for me. I used it up, but I'm not going to repurchase. Just not impressed. Maybe it would have been better if it smelled better, but meh. I have Dear Claire's Fundamental Ampoule Mist. This was lovely. I used it after toner, sometimes instead of toner. Definitely not like on top of moisturizer, because to me that does absolutely nothing, because moisturizer seals in all the hydration you have. And so to me, putting like mist on top of moisturizer is kind of like pouring water on top of buttered bread and then hoping that the bread would absorb something. But this was wonderful in addition to toner. Very nice and hydrating, no scent. This whole fundamental line is made kind of for sensitive skin and it's just been lovely. I think I've had everything from this line now except for their cream. I've had the eye products and this and the dropper thing serum. So just really, really nice. Unfortunately, I didn't have all of it at the same time. It would have been cool to try it kind of as a whole routine. But I have nothing bad to say about it. Just a nice extra dose of hydration without any fragrance. And it was just really nice. Here's Innisfree Intensive Hydrating Serum. And I laugh because this really takes me back. This, not this particular bottle, but this product was one of the very first Korean beauty things I've ever tried. When I first started getting into K-beauty, Innisfree green tea line is what I got. I had their cleanser, I've had their cleansing oil, I've had this, I've had the sleeping mask, I had the lotion. I think pretty much everything that they make I've had. And at the time, it really impressed me, but it was my very first serum ever. I've never used a serum until I had this. Now it's really fun to look back at that. Now that I've tried lots and lots and lots of different things to see how does this stack up. It's still a really good product. It's nice. It's hydrating. It makes my skin nice and soft and looking better. But it is so fragranced. And I'm not against fragrance in skincare unless you're particularly sensitive. If I have a choice of fragrance versus no fragrance, I go for no fragrance. But if something has fragrance, that doesn't stop me. I still try it. I still use it. But this just, it's very strong. The scent is very strong. So I didn't love that. I got so used to not having strongly scented products lately that this just wasn't doing it for me. So I think this is probably my last bottle of it ever, but it's not a bad product. Here's Aromatica Scalp Spray. This, for some reason, the labeling all rubbed off, but this is a spray that's supposed to help keep your hair healthy and help it grow. You spray it on the scalp when the hair is clean and kind of rub it in. It smells slightly minty, and honestly, I don't think that it did that much. I mean, it's really hard to track what exactly one product does, but I've tried several different kinds of sprays, and some of them did seem to make the hair grow quicker. And with this one, I just couldn't tell. So I don't think I'm repurchasing that. And if you have a favorite like scalp treatment, let me know. But this one, for some reason, it just fell short for me, but I can't quite place my finger as to why. I don't know. And the bottle also is very tiny. It looked a lot bigger online, I would say. I know that I could always look at the volume, and I know this is sold by volume, but I thought it would be a little bit bigger because most of the other scalp products that I've bought of this type was bigger. I have some Huang Jisu toner pads, and these are called peeling pads. Yeah, they say Radiance peeling pads, but do not confuse them with like Neogen wine gauze peeling pads or their green tea peeling pads. Those are meant to be only used once to twice a week. They really are an exfoliating step. These ones are very, very mild. They are a daily toner pad, very large, as you can tell, embossed. There are other companies that make similar things. And yes, while this is probably very mildly exfoliating, it's not something where if you're using it every day, it will damage your skin barrier. At least it didn't for me. Like, this is very mild, okay to use every day. I used it every day in the mornings. I don't cleanse my face in the morning, but I like having a toner pad to sort of wipe off if there's anything left from the night before, and then go straight into my toner and all the other things. So nothing bad to say, I really like them. And there were a lot in here. There were 60 pieces, so this lasted me quite a while. The mugwort ones from this line are also great, but the sugar ones, the no-rinse sugar ones that are supposed to be the cleansing pads, are total crap. Do not buy those. Then I have Claire's Youthful Glow Sugar Mask. And this is such an interesting product. It's almost like a mask and a cleanser at once. It has this creamy, almost like an oil cleanser base. Well, not an oil cleanser, like a balm maybe base. But then it also has some exfoliating pieces in it. And it's sugar, so it's very mild. I don't mind physical exfoliants occasionally, as long as you don't rub super, super intensely. You know, then it's okay. I actually kept the box because the instructions are very interesting. It says, cleanses makeup and provides mild exfoliation while moisturizing the skin for a glowing complexion. And then it says, with dry palms, apply an adequate amount of cleanser onto wet face, gently massage in circular motion, rinse with warm water, or use as a nourishing mask. Simply leave on for 10 minutes and then rinse with warm water. So that's strange, right? Is it a cleanser? Is it a mask? Is my face supposed to be clean? Or is this to clean it? But if it's to clean it, then that would be like an oil cleanser stage, right? So where's the foaming cleanser? So what I did, the way that it worked best for me, is I would double cleanse my face. So oil cleanser, foaming cleanser, and then apply this, leave it on for 10 minutes. And then right before rinsing it off, very gently kind of massage, just very, very gently, and then rinse off. And it leaves behind a little layer of something nourishing. I don't know, it just feels like you have something on your skin that's pleasant. It's a good thing. So afterwards, I didn't need a whole ton of steps, really. Sometimes just a moisturizer, sometimes maybe a serum and something else. So very interesting product, but it was kind of hard to fit into my routine. So I don't think I would repurchase it, but it was worth a try. I mean, I like how smooth it made my skin and everything else. It's just the whole, like, use it as a cleanser, use it as a mask part is still a little bit confusing to me. A much less confusing exfoliating product is the Swanee Coco P-Line BioCell Soft and More Black Sugar Peeling Gel. And this is a peeling gel with some black sugar pieces in it. It still peels just like any other peeling gel does, but it also had these little black sugar pieces. Very, very gentle, super nice to use. I've reviewed it before in my blog. I'll put a link in the description box. Nothing bad to say. Wonderful product. Would happily use it again. The Purito sleeping mask. I know Purito is under scrutiny lately with the whole sunscreen deal. And I honestly, I can't say that I'm unbiased in that whole thing because I like Purito as a brand. I've never accepted money from them, but I have had PR from them. I've been their customer. I've purchased their products when they were just in the beginning stages, when they only had some serums in their lineup and nothing else. I mean, I liked them before anybody even knew about them. And so I sincerely hope that this was some oversight, not on their part, that this was a lab error or something else. I really sincerely hope that they were not involved in this, that it's not something that they knew about or chose not to say anything. I mean, I just really, really hope. I mean, if they're crooks, okay, but I really hope they're not. Regardless of all of that, regardless of their sunscreen stuff, they make some other wonderful things, and this is one of them. The Purito Dermite Cica Barrier Sleeping Pack. It's a fragrance-free, really wonderful sleeping mask, although it's really light enough to be used as just a cream, like even in the mornings. And anytime I had breakouts or redness, I would use this, and it's just so nice. Soothed the skin, really helped calm down the redness. Not sticky, not heavy, but still moisturizing. Really lovely. I would highly recommend this to anybody who has like sensitive skin, acne prone skin. Of course, review the ingredients for anything that you personally might be sensitive to. I have a couple soaps here from this company called Town or Tune, T-O-U-N. One was supposed to be a face soap, and I've tried it as a face soap and it's fine, but I have so many foaming cleansers for my face that I actually ended up using it on the body. It was really nice and very mild, non-drying. And then this one was a menthol soap. So good, wasabi menthol. I was a little bit scared actually to use it at first, but it is supposed to help with sore muscles, which mine are sore all the time from working out, and it smelled so good. Definitely avoid sensitive areas when using it, because it has this invigorating minty tingle that you may not want to have in your sensitive areas, if you know what I mean. But just as a body soap, it was really nice. They have this Wonder Duo Biologically Skin, the Aquatide Resurface Serum and the Brightening Peptide Ampoule. And these are supposed to help even out the skin tone and help with aging. I was hoping that they would help with my little freckles and such. And the marketing materials say best used together, so that's how I use them. The serum was very nice, a little bit thicker than water, but not sticky and not heavy. The ampoule, a bit thicker than that and kind of milky white. I did notice that both of them together made my skin really nice and soft, kind of made it glow and look healthier. And I really like this. And I like the brand in general. They're very innovative. They made this Aquatide thing that is based on all this research on cell aging. I couldn't regurgitate it all to you if I tried, but you can definitely look that up. On their website, they have plenty of information and all the different science stuff. And I've reviewed other things by this brand before, and it's really interesting. They make also a really good chemical sunscreen. If you want something without white cast, it's really good. So far, I think everything I've tried by them has been really wonderful, and they make my favorite of all time hand cream as well. My second and last out of my stash, Let Me Skin Mask. I talked about their other version, the honey one, in my previous empties video. This one was the pink berry. So nice, smelled amazing. Very similar, I would say, to the Lemieux mask, which is pretty expensive. I think this is a little bit better priced, although I got it as PR. It's just a really nice clay mask. I don't love the packaging. At first, it was really cool to squeeze it out, but then as you get lower into here, this is enough for multiple uses. It becomes really difficult to get it out. I ended up wishing I had one of those squeeze things, like what you put on a toothpaste, but big enough for this to squeeze it all out. I didn't want to cut it up because then I couldn't show you the package in my empties video, but I don't know, just not a fan. Maybe a tube or a jar would have been better. I don't know about this kind of thing. But the mask itself was good. Soaks up the impurities, makes the skin nice and soft, makes the pores appear smaller. And like I said, the smell is awesome, just really contributes to the overall experience. I am so proud of myself, everyone. I actually managed to finish a lip mask before it expired. Like, has anybody ever done that? I can say that I did now. This was a J. Estina Jewel. Actually, I don't remember what it's called. It's J-Estina. That's the definitely the brand name, but it's Jewel something. Jewel Tension Mask. I don't know. It was a lip mask. Very similar to Laneige in the look. Slightly pinkish. Gave a little bit of a tint to the lips, or just a bit of like a hue to the lips. Can be used overnight. I also use it in the morning, during the day, because my lips have been super dry. I would say it feels actually texturally a little bit better than Laneige. It's not as thick. It's still very occlusive, but it's just not as heavy. And a smaller jar, so it makes it a little bit more manageable to actually finish up. So I would definitely use this up again. Although I just purchased some stuff that comes in tubes, like in squeeze tubes, because I actually prefer that format. My nails are pretty short, but as they get a little bit longer, I find that dipping my fingers into this, the stuff gets under my nails, and I just don't like that sensory wise. So I've been more into like squeeze tubes and twist things, but this was good. If you like a tub format, definitely check this out. I have a toner from Round Lab. This is their Docto toner. Very nice, really watery in texture, mildly exfoliating. It doesn't have any exfoliating acids. If I remember correctly, it has something like a sugar cane or something like that. That's just a little bit exfoliating, just enough to over time make your skin softer and smoother, but not enough to cause any kind of irritation or any sort of barrier damage. I really enjoyed it. Very nice. It's not particularly it's not necessarily enough for me by itself in the winter. I like thicker toners, especially at night. Something with more of a consistency of Claire's toner or like the Purito Green Level toner. But this watery one is a good first step just to get extra water in there. And then it's really nice for mornings. And I think it would be really good as it gets warmer for people with combination skin or oily skin like mine, because again, it's hydration without the heavy. But in the winter, in the evening, I need something a little bit heavier for me to really be happy with it. And I have some makeup. Can I count this as empty? I think maybe. Technically, these are not empty, but I'm going to toss them because it's been long enough now and I think they're drying out. Also, I just have some new stuff that I should be using instead of these. So this one is Lash King. I think the actual brand though is Shiseido, even though it doesn't say it on here. It's a really nice mascara, very waterproof though. I actually need a special makeup remover for it. Like a waterproof makeup remover to remove it, but it has a brush like this and little fibers. Can you see that? So it's supposed to make your lashes a little bit longer and thicker. It wears really well, doesn't run, doesn't smudge. I really enjoyed it, and it was, I think, my first Japanese mascara. Actually, no, because this next one is also Japanese, but it was one of my very, very first pieces of Japanese anything. So I really enjoyed it, and it served me well, but I think it is time to go bye-bye. This one I bought kind of by mistake is the Kiss Me Heroine Advanced Film Long and Curl Mascara. I thought for some reason that it was supposed to be a tubing mascara that rinses off with water. Not so much. You can't rinse this with anything. When I bought this, all I had to work with as far as makeup removers was a cleansing oil, and it wouldn't come off like at all. It didn't matter how many times, what kind of cleansing oils, this was there to stay. You could sleep on it, you could cry in it, you could run under rain in it. Nothing makes this thing come off, period. So it's wonderful though, when you have it on, it looks just long lashes, nicely separated, no clumps, obviously no smudging, but I did have to buy a special waterproof makeup remover to get this off, because, and then with that, no problem, comes off, no big deal, doesn't irritate the eyes, but it's definitely not for people who are hoping to use a cleansing oil to remove this, because no. I mean, I've tried multiple different oils and balms. If you know of some magical cleansing oil that removes stuff like this, let me know. But yeah, I haven't found one. Well, those are my empties. I have quite a few of them, it seems. It like ebbs and flows with the empties. Some months nothing seems to be out, and then other months it's just tons and tons and tons. I always recycle everything that I can packaging wise, and I recommend you do the same. But thank you very much for watching. You can find me on my Instagram at kbeautyhobbit, on my blog kbeautyhobbit.com, and in my private Facebook group Korean Beauty Fanatics. I will see you in my next video, and until then, please remember to always listen to your skin. Thank you so much.